out a 6-point win against Florida Gulf Coast. Meanwhile, this Army team, a lot of new faces. They lost their top four scorers from a season ago. And we are underway from Bloomington. Trey Galloway with the ball in his hands.
Man, I'm really looking forward to seeing what Indiana's worked on the last 4 days. At times against Florida Gulf Coast, felt like they were a little bit stuck in the half court. Now a real opportunity to work on some things here against Army.
How about that? Top for Khalil Ware, the 7-footer, getting involved in the first play of the game.
That's a play that Indiana ran a ton last year for Jalen Hood-Schifino. That little zoom action. Xavier Johnson coming off. Army not doing a good job on the weak side. And Khalil Ware getting the jam early.
Here is one of three Army players from the state of Indiana. Charlie Peterson wearing number 34 in the starting lineup tonight. One back by Army. They will play a couple of freshmen tonight, including their starting point guard, Ryan Curry. Scovins is short on a three.
They're going to try to move the basketball. Been a tough start to Army season. Kevin Kuick in his first season as the head coach. They're going to run some motion, and they're going to move the ball from side to side. I think of some of Bob McKillop's teams at Davidson, but they have not been a good shooting team.
Manu off the mark, tapped around, scooped up by Peterson, who we were told has at least 125 tickets out tonight for all of his Indiana people. Army 0-2 to start the season with losses to Marist and Stonehill. They're trying to figure out who their go-to scorer is. Not a single player returning this year. Scored in double figures last season. As Curry knocks down a three, the freshman from deep puts Army on the board.
That's been really Indiana's problem defensively. 25 threes if you're counting the Marion exhibition game the last two. And there, Curry just coming off the handoff, and Indiana's defense just not there on the catch.
Galloway. Lob. And it's off the rim. Josh Scobins down to Peterson. Had his shot altered by Ware, who had three blocks on Tuesday night.
That's the length of Khalil Ware. Now, he can't get ducked in like that, but it's a heck of a play to recover and still find a way to put it on the glass.
Well, you mentioned Kevin Kuick in his first season. Could not be a better job for him. A man who served in the military, including in Iraq, for 10 years, won a Bronze Star, and is thrilled to be at West Point and have the opportunity to lead this military academy.
When I think when you're a head coach at the academies, it's a totally different job. You know, the student athletes are going through totally different things. There's different demands on these kids. And with his experience militarily, and then also the fact he was ROTC at Notre Dame, served in the Army, he is the perfect fit for this job.
This is not unlike the start we saw on Tuesday night. Slow offensively for Indiana.
They're still trying to find their way in the half court. This is certainly a work in progress, and boy, just that's an unforced error. Malik Renew, he's pushed out off the perimeter. Khalil Ware, he's got to duck in hard, and Renew, take a dribble, better your angle. Indiana, you got to do a better job taking care of it here to start this game.
Mike Woodson, in his third season, said after that win against Florida Gulf Coast, there's obviously a lot to work on, but one of the biggest things to start, Robbie, as a goaltending was called there on Khalil Ware, is on the defensive side of things.
No, and even a play like that, you know, if you're Xavier Johnson, you can't just get blown by Ryan Curry. That's a freshman point guard who's playing in his third college game. You're in Assembly Hall. If I'm Xavier Johnson, I'm thinking I am setting the tone, and I'm pressuring this dude every time he's got it.
Johnson a three. Knocks it in. Had a big one in the second half against Florida Gulf Coast and is on the board here on a Sunday night in Bloomington.
He really came alive with that three-guard lineup. Sparked that Indiana comeback and win against Gulf Coast Tuesday night. Defense!
It's an Indiana team with 10 new players, and as you mentioned, still trying to figure things out on both sides of the floor, including who's going to be responsible for getting a bucket when you have to have it. It's Pearson drills a triple and then looks up to his cheering section here at Assembly Hall.
Mom and dad went to Indiana. His great-grandfather played here at IU. You have to think that for Charlie Pearson, that shot going down felt really good. Army has had a hard time scoring this season, averaging only 49 points a game, but so far, advantage.
Even though Indiana came away with a win, they shot the ball pretty well from the floor against Florida Gulf Coast, 51%, but they only had 11 assists. That was one of the things that Mike Woodson pointed to, needing to move the ball better offensively.
I just thought it stuck at times. That's another time. Yeah, that's going to be another one. I mean, that's another unforced error by IU.
Fourth of the first half. Barker turns it right back over to Johnson. Full head of steam. Nothing Army could do there but foul to stop the momentum.
This is a freshman in McKenzie Mbako. I mean, this is where you've got a ball fake. If you're going high, it's got to be a fake low and then go high. If you're going low, you fake up top and then you throw the bounce pass. It's just not good enough. And Gabe Cupp's a player who really changed the game. You can hear it with the crowd, subbed in early. I do think, though, Indiana's defense can help their offense. You know, you force a turnover, Xavier Johnson, that open floor, transition can be IU's friend. Look for them anytime they can, and they need to get out and look to run.
Xavier Johnson with the basketball here. Remember, he had that foot surgery last season. He's only able to play 11 games. Thrilled that he was awarded the waiver to come back for an additional year of eligibility, and he is headed to the free throw line. But you mentioned Gabe Cupps. He played 19 minutes in a tight game against Florida Gulf Coast on Tuesday.
Just his defensive intensity came in and changed the game. Had 5 points, had 2 steals, played 19 minutes. But when he came in to be a part of that three-guard lineup with Xavier Johnson and Trey Galloway, Indiana went on that run and was able to close the game out. Made a big shot late, plays with a lot of confidence, and certainly Mike Woodson has a lot of confidence in him.
We asked Mike Woodson on Tuesday at the shoot-around before the Florida Gulf Coast game, you know, what is it about Gabe Cupps that you really like? He said, I love his toughness.
Yeah, and he said he does all the little things that help you win. And that's certainly a good way to see the floor as a young player. Doing some of those winning plays and those little things that just help your team.
Scoven's a three and puts it down. This is a team that has shot 25% from downtown in their first two games. Tonight they've already made three.
Yeah, Scoven's just 2 of 8 their first two games for Army, but they're Malik Renew playing a little bit off him, guarding a smaller player, and Army with some confidence shooting the basketball. Only 25% from three for them on the year. They have not been a good shooting team. In fact, they're 360th in offensive efficiency. They're averaging 49 a game. They already have 11, and we're just 5 minutes into the game.
Well, Kevin Kuick, at the end of their shoot-around today, told his guys, if the shot is there, take it. Enjoy the moment playing on this big stage as Xavier Johnson takes off on the baseline.
With a nice screen, Army trying to shoot the gap. Xavier Johnson popping out to that three-point line and playing off a closeout. They're worried about him as a shooter. He's already knocked down one from three, and wisely, using his speed, just takes that thing right to the rim.
Johnson with 7 of Indiana's 9 points. Gabe Cupps knocking it loose from Dylan Blair.
That's what I was talking about earlier. Freshman point guard, not Ryan Curry this time, but Dylan Blair, who's also a freshman. Gabe Cupps just not giving him any room to breathe. That point guard shows weakness. Gabe Cupps is going to try to make a play on it.
G.J. Small tries a three. Gabe Johnson fighting for the rebound. C.J. Gunn, fresh into the game, comes up with it.
I'm curious to see what C.J. Gunn looks like here tonight. Only played 9 minutes the other night, missed his 2 shots. He's a guy that's got to take a jump for this Indiana team.
Malik Renew, and
Nifty move up and under. The post-entry pass really led the way there. Army's help defense nowhere to be seen. That defender gets pushed up top. Nice job by Renew getting position early, but the pass on time and on target.
Renew fighting with Abe Johnson, and a jump ball is called.
Indiana is so to the basketball in their help defense that naturally they're just going to give up some open threes. We saw that a lot against Florida Gulf Coast. Open shots off limited or no action. And that was another case right there where the help defender is so far to the basketball that it's a long run and you're going to give up something from the perimeter. You're taking that drive away, but those three-point shots are going to be there for Army.
Saw Florida Gulf Coast hit five of the first six threes in the second half in a game in which they led by six at one point in the second half. Down to Peterson with four to shoot.
Gotta go.
And it's off the fingertips of C.J. Gunn. Good to see Peyton Sparks in the game. Missed the regular season opener against Florida Gulf Coast with a lower body injury. Somebody they're really excited about, the Ball State transfer.
Yeah, really like his motor. Guy that's a good communicator on this team, which is, I think, something that they certainly need. We saw it today at shoot-around. Mike Woodson preaching about their communication and talking. And it's going to be something that, without some of their leadership from last year, is going to have to be continued to get worked on. They're not where they need to be yet.
Three on two. Kick out to Renew.
Good pass, though. Xavier Johnson saw that thing the whole way and set Renew up beautifully. Shot just didn't go.
Small. And a jarred loose. Diving on the floor, Peyton Sparks. And it goes off the big fella, and it will remain Army basketball.
Some missed opportunities for Indiana the last couple plays. Here, that ball off the foot of T.J. Small, and I honestly thought that Peyton Sparks could have probably just picked it up. I mean, you love the effort and the energy. I think that's one of those where it's maybe just think a little harder and not think harder, not play harder, right? Just pick it up and go.
Was the MAC freshman of the year his first season at Ball State. Grew up an IU fan, thrilled to be donning the Indiana colors. And now another newcomer into the ball game. I'll check. Yeah, it is. It is Anthony Walker, number four, the transfer from Miami. End of the shot clock, and it just rolls out for Jared Cross.
This for Indiana is really their second unit. This is like an NBA-type substitution pattern here where you have no starters on the floor.
And an offensive foul drawn by Army. That is Charlie Peterson stepping in there.
He came over and totally paid the price. Caleb Banks, full head of steam, beats the primary defender. But clearly, got Charlie Peterson. He is camped out there and takes it right to the chest.
How about Charlie Peterson back in his home state? Knocked down his first three of the season, now drawing a charge.
This game, you know it means a lot to him because of his connections to Indiana. Pretty cool to see him come out and play well early.
Gabe Cumps, the freshman, running the point with Xavier Johnson out of the game. Picked off by Small. And then Cumps stuck his hand in there to jar it loose. Was ultimately tagged with a foul, but good effort play by the freshman from Dayton, Ohio.
Decision on playing in the NCAA tournament or the NIT, and the NIT was thought of as the better event. And how appropriate for Army to come into Assembly Hall this year with the passing of Coach Knight. And these are two programs that don't play ever, but
they've never
do
played
this year. And you know what, how appropriate for that to happen this season.
Ryan Curry falling down, knocks down a triple, and that is his second three of the game.
This is a three-point defensive problem for Indiana. It happened against Marion, it happened against Florida Gulf Coast, and Army is getting it done from three. They've already made four, and they're shooting 40% from downtown. Double
team comes on Walker. Cubs with 10.
This group out here with Indiana, how do they score? It's the second unit. Just not the main guys that are going to score the rock for this team are on the bench.
Sparks, second chance won't go. And Banks on the third opportunity draws a foul. And that is the sixth foul on Army. One more and it puts Indiana in the bonus. You know, we were talking during the last commercial break. This is eerily similar to the game against Florida Gulf Coast. It started slow, disjointed offensively, but Florida Gulf Coast got foul trouble until IU went to the free throw.
I think the difference is Army has come out and played two games where they've really struggled, and Florida Gulf Coast is a team that can win their league. This has not been a good offensive team, and Army's gotten it done from three. The turnover's a little bit concerning. I don't know who's going to score right now for the Indiana Hoosiers with who's on the floor.
Army already with four made threes. A team that has shot 25% from downtown in their first two games. Backdoor cut, open, and finished by A.J. Allensback.
Mike Woodson's looking at Anthony Walker right now like, why did you do that? I mean, that's just a rogue gamble, and when you don't get it, you leave your defense super vulnerable. Indiana giving up a easy bucket to Army, and now another turnover.
That is the seventh Indiana turnover. Allen's back the offensive board. Back out to Peterson. And now a third opportunity for Army.
This has been a story for Indiana early in this season as well. But now you got to match up. I mean, you're just giving up a wide open shot. And Blake Barker has taken 7 2-point field goals in his three seasons at Army. That's what he wants to do. The scouting report's going to say, all he's doing is shooting threes. Indiana not finding him, and he's making a pay.
8-0 run. Gun. Tough jumper on the baseline.
I wonder how long Mike Woodson is going to roll with this unit out here. They have not been good.
Barker pulled the trigger on a deep three their last time down the floor. Curry off the screen, good feed, and a foul drawn by A.J. Allen's back underneath.
Army has got it rolling, an 8-0 run over the last two plus minutes. Here's Anthony Walker, he thinks he can get this steal. Charlie Peterson turns just at the right time, and he finds A.J. Allen's back who gets the layup. And now off the offensive rebound, you've got multiple second chances. They never find Blake Barker. I know he hasn't shot the ball great from three this season, just 20%, 2 of 10. His numbers tell you that's what he's out there to do. He's not taking shots from two. He is hunting threes when he's in the game.
Well, now Trey Galloway comes back on, but still the majority of what you referenced as the second unit on the floor right now for Indiana, but perhaps the veteran Galloway and provide a spark offensively.
You get a lane violation. Indiana is just not, they're not locked in here in the first half. This is a funky free throw, but you'd already seen him shoot one. That was the second shot.
Well, Army has not been good at the free throw line this year, shooting just above 50% as a team.
They are 337th in Division I basketball from the line.
But you mentioned offensive efficiency. They're in that ballpark as well, and yet here they are on an 8-0
run. They shot the ball from three much better here at Assembly Hall.
Banks hits that with a timely three.
They needed that. Really, that's just Caleb Banks making a tough shot. They didn't generate him an open look. The ball swung around the perimeter, and he took a semi-contested shot and knocked it down.
Five to shoot. Curry defended by Banks.
I said this in the Florida Gulf Coast game. I want to see Indiana dictate some things defensively. You know, they're just kind of letting Army run their stuff. I just think that with the guards they have, and Galloway and Xavier Johnson and Gabe Cupps out there, heat the ball up. You know, make Army uncomfortable. Try to help your offense with your defense.
Well, they just brought in their eraser on the back end, Khalil Ware, who had three blocks on night one on Tuesday. Picked off by Barker. And it leads to two for Quabina Davis.
Just a casual turnover again. Craig Galloway just thinking this ball can swing, and Army opportunistic jumping out.
Eight Indiana turnovers to just five made field goals.
You can see Army's starting to believe that they can play in this game. You let teams hang around, and you see this, the ball going in a little bit. Indiana just not sharp with their passes. They've got eight turnovers here in this first half. Trey Galloway this
night. They have gotten into the grill of IU and made them uncomfortable offensively.
Well, Kevin Kuick has quite the basketball pedigree. I mean, he coached under Thad Mata. He's coached under Brad Stevens, Bob McKillop. So you think about some of the people that he's seen and learned from. Learned from some of the best. He had his Army team prepared, and now out of the timeout, they're going a little 2-3 zone.
And a portion of the IU first unit back into the game, and Ware on cue finds Walker, two newcomers.
Really passed the ball well in that Florida Gulf Coast game, and there, the smart play. That defense commits up their line to contest his shot. He just dumps it right down to Anthony Walker.
Good rebound by Ware, leads to a run out. Johnson will pull it back. Galloway going right around the bigger Peterson. And Galloway on the board for the first time tonight.
There's that zoom action again, and this time it's Trey Galloway coming off. He freezes Charlie Peterson, then uses his speed to get all the way with his right hand.
Small. Bumped by Galloway. Deep three, and it goes down. Dylan Blair from way downtown, the sixth triple of the night for Army.
That's just Trey Galloway losing track of it. Comes to the ball, gets the handoff, and Indiana's defense really struggling to defend the three-point line.
And they are pushing Khalil Ware way out from beyond the post. Uses that long wingspan, and the tap back goes for Johnson plus one.
You love the hustle from Xavier Johnson there. You don't see your point guard get to the offensive glass all that often. He just refuses to be blocked down. Khalil Ware going up, and Xavier Johnson, great effort. That's a bucket that Indiana certainly needs. You can see there's just no block out there. Dylan Blair gets caught sleeping.
Johnson with 9 points, nearly half of Indiana's 20. And he draws the seventh foul on Army, so IU shooting the rest of the way.
He has certainly been the lone bright spots offensively for Indiana. Knocked down a three, he's got to the line, now getting to the offensive glass. This is smart by Army. Indiana's going to show full court pressure. You've got Josh Govins, who's playing the four. Malik Renew not going to guard the way that a guy like Xavier Johnson or Trey Galloway will.
Small. Pull up, left it short. Second opportunity. Peterson trapped by the seven-footer. Somehow snuck it up and in. And now Peterson with 5 points.
Great use of the head fake. Kept his balance. Didn't travel. Will Ware, he's looming. He knew he wanted to block that shot, pin it on the glass. But Peterson, patience there on that take.
McKenzie and Bacco, top fadeaway.
If you're taking that, you better make it. The ball hasn't really moved, it's stuck, and it's just a tough, contested look.
know you're surprised at what we've seen so far because we've been chatting about it during the commercial breaks, but when you're in a rut like this, like Indiana is, how do you get out of it if you're Mike Woodson and this team?
I think you need some of your veteran guys to step up to the plate here. Malik Renew played well in that second half against Florida Gulf Coast. He's been a non-factor offensively. Trey Galloway has been quiet. Their best players outside of Xavier Johnson just haven't played all that well.
To what would you attribute this slow start against Army?
Well, they turned it over early, and I think they're still, and this shows you right here, guys not being in the right places. Certainly a work in progress in the half-court offense. We've talked a lot about that, not just in this game, but for the Florida Gulf Coast one as well.
And maybe that's to be expected a little bit early on in the season.
No, right? But Army is still a team that lost to Stonehill and scored 44 points, and sure, they have 26 points with 4:14 to go in the first half. Indiana has missed free throws. They turned the ball over. Now you commit a foul, 80 feet from the basket.
It goes against Mackenzie Mbako. Just the fourth foul of the half for IU, who trails by five. This is Army's third game since Monday. And as you talked about, losses to Marist and Stonehill. And they did not shoot the ball particularly well in either game. And frankly, they're not tonight either. 37%, but they've hit open threes.
They've also gotten seven more cracks at it with, sure, the offensive glass and some of the turnovers in Indiana.
Bingo. Eight Indiana turnovers. Five to shoot. A three from Small.
And Xavier Johnson is lucky. I mean, TJ Small, he relocates, and he's just not close enough, especially with that shot clock winding down.
Double team comes. Renew finds Ware for a jam.
Nice look there from Renew. Army not doing a good enough job on that backside. They're bringing the post trap, and rightfully so with their size disadvantage. But when you truck casual, the turnovers, the defensive glass has been an issue at times once again with an Army team that doesn't really offensive rebound and then just giving up too many threes. Army, a team that has not shot the ball well all year long. They played two games, 25% from three. But today it's been a different story. They've knocked down six of them, not on a great percentage, but Indiana certainly giving them up again.
10 of Army's 26 points have come off of 8 IU turnovers. And they lead it by 3 here with 3 minutes to play in the first half. Scovins gives it up to Curry. 5 to shoot. Curry, desperation floater, goes down over the 7-footer, Khalil Ware.
You can tell Curry was feeling just the impact of Khalil Ware at the rim. He floated that way up there over the top of the outstretched arms, and the shot clock makes a heck of a play.
Yeah, he didn't like the foul call. He was tagged with a foul against Xavier Johnson, but here he is beating the shot clock.
That's just a freshman playing in his third college game, beating his primary defender off the bounce and dealing with one of the elite shot blockers in the Big Ten Conference, floating it right over the top of him.
That's funny. We were chatting before the game. So many new pieces for both teams. For Army, this is the first time their program has ever played IU. First time they've ever made the trip to Assembly Hall. How would some of these freshmen in particular, like Ryan Curry, respond to the big environment? Probably he's got 10 points on 4 of 6.
I would say pretty good. Kevin Kulik did give the Hoosiers talk,
yeah, he did,
before the game. He asked if they could measure the bucket. Out the tape measure.
I said, guys, don't make this bigger than it is. Yeah, they put their pants on just like we do. They play basketball just like we do.
They have come out and certainly played and looked like they feel as if they belong out here with Indiana. And that's a compliment to Army, but I would say that if I'm Indiana, I'm taking that as a diss. No offense to Army's basketball team, but they're 0-2. They've lost to two teams that certainly are not by any means college basketball powers. I just think Indiana, if I'm looking at this, I'm taking offense. But Army is dictating a lot of things in this game.
Peterson has been active around the rim tonight. He is headed to the free throw line for two shots. And that is the first foul on Khalil Ware, fifth on the team. Peterson, one of three players on the Army roster tonight from the state of Indiana. A lot of Army fans in attendance. Peterson with at least 125 tickets out. And you reference his great-grandfather, Carl, playing at Indiana in the 20s. There are his parents.
What a special deal. Students here at Indiana back in their college days and now get to see your son play at Assembly Hall and play well.
Big IU family. In fact, the Army team got a chance to go to dinner at the Peterson household in Indianapolis last night.
What was on the coffee table?
An IU basketball history book.
Had to put that away.
Put that away tonight. Bacco, a much-needed jumper. And those are his first 2 points of the contest.
We saw that against Florida Gulf Coast. Just a simple pin in. Let him come off that pin down and go to work from 15 feet.
Barker on the drive, set out of bounds by Malik Renew, and it'll stay here. Five on the timer for Indiana. At all. So a chance here for IU to tie or take the lead. Can't believe I'm saying that with 1:23 left in the first half.
After all this.
But here we are.
They still, this game has not gotten away from them.
And Mike Woodson calls a timeout. But, you know, we had a chance to hang out.
Different set of circumstances than anything that we see in the Big Ten. I commend these dudes so much because
it's impressive.
You're just dealing with so much other stuff.
It is not the typical collegiate experience.
I think about my last year at Purdue, my fifth year. I was done with my degree, really, so I took golf and 6 credit hours. It's a little bit different than that schedule.
Johnson gives Indiana a lead with a three-pointer, and he has 15 tonight in the first half.
He's been Indiana's best offensive player, and it's not been close. They've needed a spark, and Xavier Johnson, a six-year player, playing just like that, exactly what you'd expect from a veteran guy.
He has been up for the point guard,
just making things happen in a half where Indiana needed a spark.
West Point with the basketball. Leads to a three. Shot was altered. Might have gotten tipped. Skolman's there underneath. And with the left hand, scoops it up and in.
But even on that play, McKenzie Mbako just totally loses track of the shooter. And then the defensive glass again. It's an air ball. But you've got to find your man and you have to check out.
Malik Renew, offensive foul. Drawn by Josh Govins, and that is the sixth on the team.
Get Renew for the clear out here. Skovins moving the feet. Get him for just kind of lowering that shoulder and displacing Skovins. There's that. Whenever you get that forearm going, officials are going to get you for the offensive foul.
Barker, and now a foul goes against.
I was about to say, if you're Army, you just cannot turn the ball over here. Charlie Peterson didn't come set on that dribble handoff. That's his second foul, so certainly something. He's been productive for Army. You've got to come set. You can see he's just still a bit of happy feet as he sets that screen on Trey Galloway.
So he heads to the bench with two. And Abe Johnson, the senior from Missoula, Montana, comes in. He is defending Khalil Ware. Less than 10 seconds to play in the first half. Johnson, the scoop feed. And Renew, a nifty twirl with the left hand, goes down. 2 seconds. And Barker gets it off. And just off the mark. So IU squeaks out a one-point lead headed into the halftime locker room. Xavier Johnson leading all scorers with 15.
Indiana has got to do a better job of finding some of these shooters. I think at times maybe you could make the argument that they've overhelped on the dribble drive and given up looks. They've got to contest. And I would just like to see Indiana try to dictate some things on the defensive end. Use your athleticism, get some pressure, and make Army feel uncomfortable offensively.
Well, it's hard to believe for a team that is ranked so low in offensive efficiency like Army is, that they've taken 9 more shots in the game than Indiana. Barker had it tipped away. Corralled by Curry, who had 10 in the first half, and he's now up to 12.
Ryan Curry.
And he puts Army back on top.
He has been terrific. And you're talking about a freshman point guard coming into Assembly Hall and playing the way that he has, and coming off a game against Stonehill where he did not score and went 0-4, playing with a lot of confidence for this freshman.
The message from Army head coach Kevin Kuick to his team at the end of the shoot-around: just have fun. Take the big shot. Enjoy the moment. They seemingly have through the first 20 minutes.
Curry making another play, throwing it up. He's doing a little bit of everything out here.
Thought about a three. It's a West Point team that is 0-2 on the season. A number of new faces. They lost their top 4 scorers from a season ago. Curry. And there's a foul, and that is the 3rd on Charlie Peterson, which could spell trouble for West Point, which does not have a very deep bench. And they will go to it early with Abe Johnson.
That foul at the end of the half is just a killer, and it was another moving screen player control foul. Seemingly one where you could have avoided it end of the half. Now you get one first or second play that they Army has the basketball. That's a big loss because Charlie Peterson did some positive things for Army offensively in that first.
How long do you keep him out if you're Kevin Kuick?
Probably depends. It depends on the game flow. We got moving screens everywhere right now. I think as long as you're hanging in here, keep him on that sideline for an extended period of time. But also don't want him to lose. It's hard when you're in foul trouble. You lose that rhythm. I think if you're hanging in there, you can bring him back around maybe 10 or 11. Bring him back there, maybe 12.
Peterson's parents in attendance, along with 120-plus other friends and family. Grew up in Indianapolis, one of 3 players on this Army team with Indiana ties. Good pass, and Renew finishes on the dime from Johnson, his 3rd assist.
Nice pass, nice push right there by Xavier Johnson. Indiana's got to figure out what they're doing with ball screens here. That last possession doesn't lead to a made shot with Scobins, but you can tell there's miscommunications going on out here. Guys not on the same page. It gave him a wide open look from the top of the key.
There's Davis, the team captain, with 3 to shoot. Pounded by Johnson. Great defense by Xavier Johnson. And there is less than a tick left on the shot clock. 0.8.
Xavier Johnson had him going nowhere. He just locked in right here. Moved his feet. He's a physical defender. Nice play. Individually locking down.
0.8 on the shot clock here. And put it down. A 3 ball from Blake Barker.
That's going to that baseline, fading away out of bounds. Got to get it off quickly because there's only 0.8 on the shot clock. Blake Barker, he's known for that 3-point shot. What a play right there. Shot clock winding down.
Second 3 of the game. Renew fouled. Drive into the basket. I mean, this is crazy. 0.8 seconds left. Curry struggling to get the ball in.
Yeah, Trey Galloway going removed on the first. He's right there, though. I mean, that's about as well as you could defend that play other than blocking the shot. It's one where I think if you're Indiana, you tip your cap. You hate to see it, but that was a contested tough one for a guy that was fading out of bounds at the baseline.
That's winning a game of horse every day of the week.
That over the backboard shot. Not that I don't think that did actually go over the backboard, but that was
fading with .8 and a hand in your face.
The over the backboard horse shot.
Are you making that, Robbie Hummel?
Well, I can still shoot. I can't move. I think I can make that. Don't ask me to guard anybody, but making a shot, I can do that.
Tied at 36. 3 minutes down in the second half. Curry is having a career night.
At some point, you've got to stop going under him on the handoffs. He's proven that he can make them. Just, and Indiana wants to talk about it. Mike Woodson, not happy with their defensive execution. Ryan Curry lets the crowd know about it here at Assembly Hall. Here comes the handoff.
Scored this season.
That's an incredible statistic. Army does not return a double-figure scorer. You're playing two freshmen in your starting lineup. Ryan Curry has brought it. The game against Stonehill where he didn't play all that well. Looks like a different Curry tonight. A little bit of step out here in Assembly Hall.
And playing up to the crowd on the big stage as well. Inside to Khalil Ware. And the big fella gets the friendly bounce. His first shot attempt of the second half goes down.
Army has no answer for that. They've got Abe Johnson out there playing the five at 6'8". Mike Woodson wisely, four round one, throw it right inside to Khalil Ware.
You expect to see a heavier dose of that the rest of the way.
Why not?
Abe Johnson, number 54, on the floor. Remember, Charlie Peterson, who got the start tonight for Army, on the bench with three fouls. He picked up the third one a minute into the second half.
Xavier Johnson's got to let this go. They called him for a hold right there. And remember last season, year before, times when he thought calls would go against him, he just wouldn't leave it alone. It almost distracted him as he played. He's just got to move on and play.
Defending Curry, the high scorer tonight for Army with 15. Curry looking at the clock, five to shoot. Defended by Renew. Curry had it rejected by Malik Renew out of bounds and a shot clock violation.
That is without question Indiana's best defensive possession of the night. You had Xavier Johnson into the basketball. Malik Renew off the switch, then moving his feet, staying in the play and blocking that shot out of bounds. Should go right. I don't know why that ball doesn't go right back inside top of the key. Finally found him, but Lake Renew didn't really give it a look.
Really tough shot goes down for the 7-foot transfer from Oregon.
There's no denying his talent. In Oregon last year, he certainly at times got to that turnaround jumper and had some success with it. It was a well-contested shot, but Khalil Ware showing off his ability.
Hard to believe, Robbie, but this one-point lead ties the largest lead of the game for Indiana. Scovins up the mark, and Ware with the rebound.
Johnson, boy.
A little bit shaken up, gripping that left knee. Remember, he only played 11 games last year. Foot injury required surgery.
He's grabbing that shin or calf almost.
On Big Ten Plus on Friday night against Maryland.
I feel like sports fans are finally seeing just how good of a sport volleyball is to watch.
Especially
in this league where every school has a great team.
Yeah, he has made Indiana volleyball very relevant in the Big Ten. The floater goes down. Ware with a two-hand jam. Delivery courtesy of Trey Galloway.
There's been a concerted effort by Indiana to throw the ball inside and get to the painted area. Nice job by Trey Galloway, drawing a defender and just knowing I can throw it up in the vicinity of the rim, and Khalil Ware is going to go get it.
Largest lead of the night for IU at 3. Gabe Cupps checking back into the game. 4 to shoot. Curry gives it up. Scovins. Last second three goes down, and it's Jared Cross, and they will check the monitor. That is the second such three at the end of the shot clock
corner
that we have seen in this half.
I didn't think there was any way there was
anything's going through Kevin Kuick's mind right now.
Probably, how can we, certainly it's how do we win the game? But when he goes back and looks at the film, he's going to think, we played so much better than what we did our first two games.
Well, he told us, you know, the first two games were disappointing because we didn't play nearly as well as we practiced.
They practiced.
Just don't have an answer for Indiana's positional size. Army coming out 2-3 zone from that review. Indiana getting the ball to the middle of the zone and just clearing out, letting Khalil Ware go to work.
Charlie Peterson will come back into the game with three fouls.
He ball faked, looked for other people, and said, you know what? I'm open, I'm in space, and I can beat my man one-on-one off the bounce.
Starting to heat up. Four of his shot attempts have come in this half. And Ware, again, coming off a big night. His first career double-double on Tuesday against Florida Gulf Coast was a primary reason they came away with a win in that game. Peterson fighting for the rebound, and he goes back to Indiana.
That's another three that's given up because Indiana helped so much on dribble drives. Caleb Banks was way off his man.
Blair now into the game at point guard for West Point as Ryan Curry gets a breather. Leads all Black Knight scorers with 15. Blair. Goes down, defended well by Peterson, but just a better move offensively by Ware.
Right now, Indiana has got to throw the ball inside on every possession. Army just has no answer for it. Beautiful slip, and boy, I think Peterson might have missed that layup. That thing looked like it was going right into the rim. Khalil Ware maybe giving a gift right there. Nice slip, and I don't know. From the angle we had, I thought that was going to be short into the bottom of the rim, but a little bit different there.
There's Trey Galloway. Wanted to step up in a leadership role this season. Talked to him before the game. Had a nice night on Tuesday against Florida Gulf Coast. And Malik Renew and Khalil Ware. It's been a heavy dose in the post the last couple of minutes. Indiana extends the lead.
It's got to be every time if you're Indiana. And if I'm Army, I'm thinking we have got to bring help and send some post traps. You might give up some threes, but Indiana just 3 of 8 from the three-point line. You got to live with that when you've got Renew and Ware down low.
Barker flexing his muscles as he runs back on defense.
Jumped up, went into Caleb Banks, kind of hung there and finished over the top for a guy that's known as a shooter.
Galloway plus one.
Finally some rhythm and some flow in this game. It was so choppy in the first half. Both sides starting to score. Trey Galloway, crossover dribble. There's that spin, uses his size, takes the contact. Indiana, it's been all about driving it and throwing it inside. The points in the paint have certainly been the difference in their run.
Those are the first points by an IU player in the second half, not named Khalil Ware or Malik Renew.
Indiana now up to 30 points in the paint. They need to throw it in and drive it every time.
And a timeout taken by Kevin Kuick. Largest deficit of the game for Army at 6. IU finding a rhythm in the paint. They've made their last 8. Eclipse 100 wins. Certainly left his mark on the program, Robbie, and of course, the program here at IU with many, many seasons, nearly 3 decades on the sideline, and now Kevin Kuick taking over the reins of the Army program in his first season.
This team played so much better than what they did their first two ball games.
Barker. Tested two by Malik Renew.
Even on that play, you could see Caleb Banks. Barker's coming up for the handoff, and it just took Banks a little bit of time to even register that. Khalil Ware did a nice job helping out. There's another Indiana turnover.
Make that the 12th. And then Gabe Copps picks it back off for Indiana.
Great
hands. Love this freshman.
Really good anticipation there by Copps.
Entry pass by Ware. 13 turnovers on the night for Indiana.
Renew's got the advantage there, but
doesn't have to go in immediately. You can move it, get a better angle. The thing that's tough is Indiana's bench has been almost non-existent these first two games. And you're running out of time to find them minutes before you start seeing the UConns and the Kansases
and
some of the big dogs that they're going to see on their schedule.
Well, to your point, just five bench points tonight for IU.
They had seven against Florida Gulf Coast. But that second unit came in, played together, and it was a disastrous
segment
of time.
Well, it's kind of the question you asked, Robbie. When the second unit's out there, who's your scorer?
Well, I don't think that you have to necessarily go total second unit.
Sure.
And certainly, I think Mike Woodson's just trying to see who plays well. But you can leave some guys out there.
Timeout taken by Paul Sells. I wonder if it's a clock malfunction here.
Lucky for Peyton Sparks, because he was going with one shoe.
Well, this lineup right now is sort of a mix of first unit and second unit. You've got Malik Renew and Trey Galloway, who started the game.
Right, we saw Anthony Walker, Caleb Banks, Peyton Sparks, CJ Gunn, Gabe Cups.
Yeah.
And I guess Gunn was a scorer in high school. He has not been successful as a scorer in college. And around that, Peyton Sparks had a nice year at Ball State, but I would say it's unproven at the Big Ten level. So I don't know how that group scores. I think that's what he wanted to see, and he saw that it was a struggle.
6-point Indiana lead, less than 11 minutes to play. Gabe Cups with an elbow jumper.
Army's giving that up. Ryan Curry went well under that screen. Cups wisely. That coverage just finding his spot and elevating.
Curry just came back into the game and is grimacing a little bit. That's a deep three contested by TJ Small and the 10th triple of the night for Army.
The three-pointers just continue to kill Indiana.
Galloway. Pulls it back out.
Army's got to bring some other bodies here. They're just so undermatched. In the painted area, they're going to have to bring two.
Curry gives it up to Barker. Offensive rebound. Peterson hacked, and he's got two shots coming.
Well, a lot to dislike for Indiana in that transition possession. They're not getting back to shooters. Army gets a wide open shot. And a team in the Army Black Knights that aren't known for their offensive rebounding ability, now with their ninth offensive rebound, Charlie Peterson earning a trip to the foul line with purely his effort.
Nine offensive rebounds for Army. And Florida Gulf Coast, if you remember, had 13 offensive rebounds.
It's been an issue for Indiana, even in their exhibition games. University of Indianapolis, Marion.
Good to see Xavier Johnson come back on, yeah, going into that last timeout. It looked like
maybe cramping.
Yes.
Tim Garl came out and stretching that calf out. Get some fluids in him, and they need it. Because he, first half, he was Indiana's best player. Second half, it's been more of the bigs with Ware and Renew. But they need a healthy Xavier Johnson on the floor.
Had 15 points in the first half. He's only attempted one shot in the second frame. Gives it off to Sparks with a reverse, and the Ball State transfer flashing some talent on the baseline.
Pretty two-man action there. Off those dribble handoffs, you've got Sparks, you've got Xavier Johnson, and Johnson just dropped a dime.
Curry bounce it off the head.
Those are the worst as a player, because the miss is so bad. There's that pretty pass, the pocket pass, that whole side's cleared out. Army's got to bring help from the strong side. That low man has got to be there. It's a tough action to guard.
Curry curling. Five to shoot. Back out to Peterson.
Eight cups, though. You cannot get turned down there. That big had to help. That led to that open shot.
Renew picked off by Peterson, now running the break. Curry step through. Yes, sir, with a friendly bounce. 17 for Curry tonight.
But good decision by Quavina Davis to not force the issue. Didn't like what he had, pulled it out. And Ryan Curry driving it right back in there.
And an offensive foul. And Ryan Curry is jacked up. He is eating up this moment right now, the freshman.
He's got 17 points in just his third college game. Blows right by Sparks.
This time last year, he wasn't even playing basketball because his high school season hadn't started yet.
He was at the U.S. Military
Academy
Prep School. I mean, he was there going to prep school. Now he finds himself in one of the best venues in college basketball, playing some of his best basketball of his life.
And a blocking foul goes against Gabe Cups. And you can hear the boos ringing down here from a packed house at Assembly Hall. They didn't like it. It's the second on Cups and the fourth on the team this half.
Cups trying to get in to Ryan Curry. And boy, he's just getting over the screen. The screen just kind of blocks him into him. I'm Gabe Cups, though. That's not affecting anything I do. Every time he is out there to heat the ball up, that's what he did against Florida Gulf Coast.
And another foul, Robbie. And that is now six on Indiana. So one more, and Army is shooting free throws the rest of the way.
I said this earlier, Xavier Johnson can't dwell on some of these things. Well, there's like no contact there. Not sure what the foul is.
Two on Xavier Johnson. Looking for an entry pass to Peterson.
Good help.
Davis tied up by Xavier Johnson. It's a good defensive effort by the six-year senior.
Xavier Johnson stopping the ball as that secondary defender. Quick hands. Just wraps up Quavina Davis immediately.
Jay Allen's back, number 55 in black, just checking into the game for the first time in this half. And that's great defense by C.J. Gunn. It forces the second shot clock violation of the half for Army. Kevin Kuick wanted a foul, won't get it. It is a tight one here in Assembly Hall. Four-point game, less than eight.
That story, and in the second half, Indiana has found their success throwing it inside. And I just think that it'd be wise to get those two back in the game sooner rather than later.
They scored the first 17 points of this half for IU. Did Ware and Renew, as that ball was lost out of bounds. Johnson will not maintain possession, or will he?
No, it's going to be Indiana basketball.
It is Indiana basketball. So avoiding what would have been the 16th turnover of the game for IU. 20 on the shot clock. And picked off. There is turnover number 16 and a foul to boot. And it goes against Johnson now, Robbie, who has three fouls.
It's just Xavier Johnson throwing it when a guy is not open.
That puts you gotta throw at the line the rest of the way.
If you set a good screen and the guy comes off and it's there, then throw it. But this can't be a preconceived idea where you're just going to throw it regardless.
That look says it all, I think, tonight. The frustration, Indiana just, even when they've had success. Remember, they started the half 8-for-8 from the floor. Oh. Even when they've had success, it hasn't been sustained.
No, there was that little time here early in the second half where there was some free-flowing offense, but other than that, it's been so choppy. That could have been a turnover again.
Gun down to Renew. 6 points in the half. Five to shoot. Skips it to Cups. Johnson with one. And he missed it all. Well defended by Charlie Peterson in this Army defense.
That was well done by Army. They know they're giving up so much size. They brought the post trap to Renew. They rotated out. Great contest. Might have even been tipped. solid, solid possession for the Army Black Knights.
And now Indiana does have Khalil Ware and Malik Renew back on the floor at the same time. That was such a dynamic combination to start the half.
I just think they've got to go back to that well. The trap will come, but get Army in some rotations. Just have too much positional size to exploit over the top of Army.
Army shooting 39% for the game, 31% from downtown. 10-3. Ware using that wingspan to tip it out of bounds. It'll stay with Army at 8 to shoot.
For Josh Govins in the Patriot League, when that angle's there, it's going to be a layup. But against Khalil Ware, it's just has such length to stay in plays. I would like to see Ware do his work a little bit earlier. He's letting Charlie Peterson get some position that in the Big Ten might not be so easy to get back into some of these plays.
Curry poked away, two to shoot. Heave by Barker. Almost got it there in spite of the contest.
He's already made a horse shot. That would have been number two.
That is the third shot clock violation of the half for Army. Kevin Kuick told us one of the points of emphasis, we have to get a shot up every time down the floor against Indiana tonight.
They haven't turned the ball over. That's something that they really struggled with their first two games, with 16 a game. Tonight, that's been a different story. Indiana has turned the ball over, but Army has not.
Only five in the first half for Army. They have five so far in this half. And Ware was fouled by Peterson, and that is his fourth. Sat for much of the beginning of this half, and now what do you do if you're Kevin Kuick? He will send him to the bench.
Abe Johnson's going to come in. It's just a tough matchup for Peterson. Ware catches that at the high post. He can get his game on, and Peterson put his hands on Khalil Ware. Easy call.
He has 9 points tonight in front of a large contingent of family and friends. Mother and father, John and Becky, both in attendance, grew up in Indianapolis. Three Army players from the state of Indiana relishing this moment down four at Assembly Hall. Barker on the drive, blows by Johnson, and then draws the fourth foul on Xavier Johnson.
Blake Barker is a guy that, I said this in the first half, has not taken many twos in his time at Army. And if you're Xavier Johnson, I mean, this is just not good enough. It's a straight line drive given up to a guy that wants to shoot the ball. You've got to contain the bounce. And Xavier Johnson is quick enough and good enough to do that. And it's just a lack of focus right there.
Barker's first free throw attempt of the season. Again, this team has been
the line has let them down. They're 2 of 8.
And on the season, they're 51.5%.
Regardless, though, Kevin Kuick is going to be happy with the way his team has played. The way they turned it over the first two games, and he was really concerned about them just running offense, moving it from side to side. They've done that. They haven't played scared, and they've given Indiana all they want and more here tonight.
It's been difficult for Indiana to run offense. Five turnovers in 3.5 minutes.
Turnovers have been just insane here.
Renew lobs out to Ware with the two-hand jam.
That's something where Army has had some issues all night long on the post trap. They've been able to come and get a trap on the post up, but they have not cracked down on that man at the rim. And there, Renew wisely throwing it up. Khalil Ware throwing it down.
17 points tonight for Ware, leads all scorers. Scobins left it short. Rebound Johnson. Curry a three. And he flashes a look at the IU crowd. He is having a career night. 20 points for the Army freshman.
That's an example where Khalil Ware has got to be more understanding of the situation. Malik Renew had defended that play well. And you had Ware flying through the play to try to block the shot. That leaves that big wide open down there for the offensive board.
Renew double team just gets it to Johnson, and the scoop won't go. Scoven scoops it up. Curry left open. Yes, sir.
Oh, it was out of bounds.
Wow. James Breeding, the official right behind Curry, was on top of it. And the contingent of Army fans.
Well, that heel is
Wow.
Right there.
By the slimmest of margins. But even coming back, Curry giving it to Trey Galloway a little bit.
He's letting Indiana know about it here. The crowd, the players.
20
and
points.
You know what? This play has backed it up. 8 of 12 from the field. Knocked down four threes. He's earned the right to talk.
Galloway, baseline.
That had to go in there immediately. And once it was late, it's pushed out. But Renew, why not throw it into Khalil Ware?
Curry wants it. He's got the hot hand. 20 points, the most scored by any Army player so far this season.
Indiana is just constantly in rotation here.
Barker pumps, drives, sneaks it over the outstretched arms of the seven-footer, Khalil Ware.
But that whole possession, it's just Indiana trying to play catch-up. They never do, and Blake Barker thought of him as more of a shooter, but he's proving tonight that he's getting to the rim as well.
After trailing by 8.5, Army has tied it at 58 with 3:30 to play.
Like right there, it's Khalil Ware has a clear matchup advantage.
Foul comes in, Scovins. That is his first.
My Army just...
Montgomery to Jersey. We asked Kevin Kuick, what do you like about Ryan Curry? He says he's just Jersey tough.
Yes,
chip on his shoulder.
Tough, that's right.
So Khalil Ware at the line. Ware was 17. Free throw line was a struggle for IU against Florida Gulf Coast, but Ware is 2 for 2 tonight, and IU has the lead. 3:20 to play, both teams in the bonus, and both teams with a pair of timeouts.
I just think the offense needs to run through the bigs here to finish off for Indiana. Get some high-low action, especially with Ware. Now an opportunity for a rare second chance. It's been mostly Army with these offensive rebounds, but now Indiana runs some offense.
That's just Indiana's fifth offensive rebound compared to Army's 11. And Renew, they will not count the shot. There was a foul on the floor first. And I believe it went against Abe Johnson. Indeed, that is his first. And remember, Charlie Peterson still on the bench for Army with four fouls. He picked up his third early in the half and his fourth just a few minutes ago. There is Peterson with 125 friends and family or more in attendance. The team had dinner at his parents' house a couple of nights ago in Indianapolis. Grew up an IU fan. Huge night for him and some of his other teammates who are Indiana natives. And a strong Army contingent in attendance tonight. Veterans Day weekend, enjoying the scenes at Assembly Hall. Three-point game.
Indiana has done a better job here tonight of capitalizing when they've gotten to the line. He shot a ton of free throws against Gulf Coast. But only went 19 of 30. Different story tonight, 12 of 14.
And if you look at the score, those have been paramount. Curry trying to get open. He's had the hot hand. Five to shoot. Scovins rejected by Renew, and Renew keeps possession.
If Renew didn't get it, Ware was gonna. Indiana's bigs around the basketball, and they get it done defensively on that drive.
Where do you go here if you're Indiana?
Inside.
Back to the post.
I throw it right in there to Malik Renew or Khalil Ware. Let them go to work.
Thought about a three. Gets it to the freshman who knocks it in.
It's all about playing through the post, though. Army's got to bring two. You've got him in rotation. Galloway with the extra pass. And Cuffs made a big one against Florida Gulf Coast. Makes a big one against Army. Play through Malik Renew and Khalil Ware.
So Army with one timeout remaining. Both teams in the bonus the rest of the way. Charlie Peterson, the Indianapolis native, and a senior at West Point, back into the game with four fouls.
I think this could be Ryan Curry time, the way he's played.
Defended by the freshman Cups. A little freshman on freshman action. Scalvin's a three. Puts it down.
But in the end, what the pick and roll defense? Is it a switch? Is it a drop? You can see Xavier Johnson and Khalil Ware just not on the same page, and that leads to a wide open Josh Scovins three.
Second triple of the night for Scovins. He has 8 points. 3-point game. 1:30 to play in Assembly Hall.
Throw that thing back inside. Our Army has no answer for what Indiana's bringing.
And a blocking foul on Scovins will send Renew to the free throw line.
This is all about communication, and we saw Mike Woodson at shoot-around today harping, have to talk. Xavier Johnson thinks it's a switch. Khalil Ware thinks that Johnson's getting over the top, and that leads to a wide-open shooter. Josh Scovins knocking down the open three.
You said earlier in the night they've averaged 26 threes per contest taken. Tonight they've taken 35, and they've hit 12. They're at 34%.
They fully understood that if they were going to win or hang around, it was because they were going to make a bunch of threes. They've only made 6.5 in their two games as an average, so certainly shooting it much better here tonight. They've doubled up their number.
Indiana struggled so much at the foul line against Florida Gulf Coast. Not tonight.
Army
14 of 16 from the line.
Army's left some points there. It's been the difference in the game.
Left 6 points on the line, and they trail by four. Curry, kick out. Scovins trying to go back to Curry, and it's picked off by Malik Renew. Up to Ware. Hammer time. Largest lead of the night. Check that. Second largest lead of the night at 7 for Indiana. Curry a three. The foul game will be played by Army. That was a massive turnover and run out for Khalil Ware.
Looks like Indiana is going to survive here. Again, it's finally a fast break bucket. Indiana, which is 4 fast break points, and you think about one of the strengths of their team is how athletic they are. Off that turnover, finally a run out. Galloway, what a luxury to know I can put this anywhere in the vicinity of the backboard, and Khalil Ware is going to tear the rim off.
Well, Mike Woodson said that he was fully aware of the reputation that Khalil Ware had leaving Oregon. The knock on him was that he didn't work hard, that he didn't play with effort. Well, we've seen something different in 2 games at IU. Career high 20 points tonight, and he had his first double-double of his collegiate career on Tuesday.
He's given a good effort. You know, he really has. And I think that was a question. Woodson talked about how hard he's going to coach him up, and certainly has. I think that from an effort perspective, Indiana has got to think that he's brought it from that perspective.
Curry looking to set up a three. Barker from downtown. And he missed it all. And now if you're Army, do you foul right away? Do you go for a steal?
Go for a steal, but then you're fouling quickly if you don't get that. To a total second unit, you're going to have some of those starters mixed in. But like a guy like C.J. Gunn, you know, how does he fit in? How does Peyton Sparks fit in? How does Caleb Banks fit in?
Sure.
Anthony Walker right there. You know, I think there's some real questions with this group right now that are going to have to be answered, and answered quickly, because the Connecticut Huskies are a very talented basketball team. And after Wright State on Thursday, that's who they've got next.
And then down the road, beginning of December, you start with Maryland. Then you're at Michigan. Then you play Auburn. Then Kansas. It does not get any easier for an Indiana team as you look at the schedule. And if you're playing Texas at the Empire Classic, that's a whole other ball game as well.
Indiana is playing a heck of a schedule. And I like the fact that Mike Woodson is challenging his team, especially in today's age where with the NCAA tournament, how you make it, you get quad one wins. And you do that by playing quality opponents. He's certainly the Florida Gulf Coast is a good one. Wright State is a good mid-major.
And then the high major teams they're playing, that's big boy basketball. You have got to play better if you're going to hang around with some of the teams that they're going to see.
And a tie-up. One by Curry, but it'll stay with Indiana. 15.1 left. No timeouts remain for Army. And Malik Renew will be the inbounder. Do you press the panic button at all?
No, I mean, you certainly, we're the second game in.
Yeah,
so okay. you're not pressing the panic button, but I think you certainly have to start making some strides and seeing some progress. I just think that there's been some glaring holes for Indiana in these two wins.
They too,
the good thing is, though, is that they have found ways to win
these
games.
Sure,
sure.
And, Robbie, they too are replacing four of their top five scorers
from last year. They lost leadership. They lost scoring. They lost rebounding. This is a very new team.
Two guys go to the NBA.
Yeah, you've lost a lot of talent. But if Indiana wants to be the team that they think they can be this year, some questions have to be answered.
I think the faces on the bench say it all. Just some perplexed looks, some surprised faces. Indiana, a heavy, heavy favorite tonight at home against Army. And credit to the Black Knights. They gave IU all they could handle and more. Johnson rattles in his second free throw, and so he's up to 19 points to go along with five assists and three boards. No timeouts for Army. 72-61. Curry looking for a three. Gives it up to Barker. And he puts it down. That is a microcosm of what the game has been. Army beating the shot clock. They ultimately fall 72-64. Great fight.